Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In this video, we'll be solving end chapter problem 15.14 from the Laplace Transform chapter. The question is, find the Laplace Transform of the signal. The signal is shown here. You have to calculate this Laplace Transform. There are two methods. One is the differential method. Now, this method is not given in the book, but this method has been used by the solution manual. So we'll discuss this as well. And the book method is the conventional method. So we'll also discuss this. And whichever method you are comfortable with, you can follow that method. The first differential method, a key point here is that the differential method can only be used where we can obtain impulse function after differentiation. So I hope you know what is impulse function, and we'll just now see what is an impulse function. Okay, then we'll use this differential formula, which says d square f dt square in Laplace domain will be s square fs minus this these values. Now these are the initial conditions. Normally, initial conditions are zero, because in this case especially, because there is nothing beyond or before zero, so we'll make them zero. So our equation will be now d square dt square, we can write as f double dash t, and only keep this one s square fs, and from here we can calculate the Laplace transform by using this formula. So this is how we are going to approach this question. First of all, we find the slope of this line. Slope from this formula, I hope you know how to calculate. It is 5. So the line equation will be 5t. I'm writing only the simplified equation. Similarly, this has the slope of minus 2.5. So it will be minus 2.5t. Now, if we differentiate both of these, 5t differentiation will give us 5. So it's a straight line of value 5. Similarly, minus 2.5t differentiation will give us minus 2.5 constant. So we have drawn it here. Now we need to re-differentiate, so we get the impulse. So our double differentiation will result in couple of things. First of all, the constant value differentiation will be zero. Similarly, differentiation of this will also be zero, constant value. But there is a sudden change here, so we'll get an impulse after differentiation, and this value will be now 5, and we'll write is impulse function delta t. Here it is coming down from 5 to minus 2.5, so minus 7.5 down at t is equal to 2. So we'll write it minus 7.5 delta t minus 2. And this one is going from minus 2.5 up to 0. So it will be 2.5 delta t minus 6, because it is occurring at t minus 6, or at t is equal to 6. So this is our impulse function. And now we can write the equation. So equation will be sum of all three. So this is the double differentiation in time domain. Now we have to go to Laplace domain. So we know f double dash t in Laplace is s square fx. 5 and delta in Laplace is 1. So this will be 5 into 1, that is 5. Now here we have the time shift. So we have to use the time shift property. This is the time shift property. And in the Laplace domain, it will be e raised to the power minus asfs. Now in our case, fs is 1, because this is our main function. This is what we are shifting. So fs will be 1. So now for this part, it will be minus 7.5 e raised to the power minus as. A is 2 here. So minus 2s multiply by fs is 1. So multiply by 1, whether you write or don't, doesn't matter. And similarly, the third part is 2.5 e raised to the power minus 6s. And from here now we'll find Fs by dividing by S square both sides. So this is the answer for this question. And now we'll do the conventional method, slightly lengthy, but it is better to learn and know the technique. This is the first part of the graph. We have separated the first part. Slope we had already calculated, repeat here, 5. Now we'll write the complete equation. That is y is equal to mx plus c, the f1t is 5t plus intercept c is y intercept, which is 0. So it will be just 5t. And if you want, you can follow the complete procedure. F1t you can put 0 here, t again 0 here, so you can calculate c, which is 0. Anyway, now our equation, the line will be 5t, but there is a problem. This is unbounded because as we keep increasing the time, this line will keep on increasing. So we don't want this portion, we want to remain only up to this part. So what we need to do is, first of all, before we do that, let me give you a concept that anything which is on the right hand side of zero line, we can assume that it is being multiplied by ut, and u is just 1, so anything multiplied by 1 does not change. So if the equation, now we can write it as 5t ut. This is a more formal way of writing. Now the question here that we want to get rid of this portion. How to do that? Okay, we'll multiply this by ut minus 2. That means at this point ut, right of this is 1 and left of this is 0. So 0 multiplied by this portion will be eliminated, and the upper portion multiplied by 1 will remain. So what will be left is this portion, and it will be called 5t ut minus 2. So from here, if we subtract this portion, we will be left with only the desired portion. So the desired portion we can write is 5t ut minus this 5t ut minus 2, and this we are naming as f1t. So this is the first part. The second part will take similar approach. Slope of the line minus 2, 5, complete line equation following the same technique. Putting now 2 as t and f1t as 10, we can calculate the slope, which is 15. So our line equation will now be f2t is minus 2.5t plus 15. So here also we are writing minus 2.5t plus 15. But same problem here, that if you write this, that means it can go on the left side, it can also go on the right side, because the t we have to, t is unbounded in this case, we have to limit this. So what is required? We want to eliminate this part first of all, and also we want to eliminate this part. So to eliminate the first part, we just multiply it by ut minus 2. So this is 1, so multiply 1 by this, and here it is 0 multiplied by this, it will be 0. So after multiplication, this will be the equation, this multiplied by ut minus 2, and the left part is gone, multiplied by 0. Now we have to take care of the right part. So let's see. Take care of this part. Now how do we write this? What we'll call this part? Okay, if we multiply this again by ut minus 6, then what will happen? This portion will go away, so only this part will be left. And so whatever is left, we can write it as the 2.5t16 multiplied by now ut minus 6. So this is the part, our unwanted part. So from here, if we subtract the unwanted part, we'll have the desired line. So the desired line can be obtained from the first equation minus the second equation, and we call it F2T. So it will be the simplified form of this. So this is our F2T. Now F1T and F2T, we adding the two, we can get the complete circuit. So adding and then doing some manipulation, getting the same terms together. So this is our final value in time domain. Now we have to, from time domain, we have to go to the Laplace domain. Now this is T here, T, U, T or T. The Laplace transform of this function will be 1 over s square. And these are the time shifted functions. Again, we'll use the same formula that we used previously for time shift, e raised to the power minus as fs. Now in this case, we are shifting the t. So t is the main function. So fs will be 1 over s square, the Laplace transform of t. So let's now put in the values. 5t ut, so it will be 5 over 5 multiplied by 1 over s square, so 5 over s square, minus 7.5 e raised to the power as or e raised to the power minus 2s multiplied by 1 over s square, so multiplied by 1 over s square, or we can just write the denominator s square, and similarly this one. So this is again, we have found the Laplace transform, and it is the same answer that we got in the case of a differential technique. So I hope you have been able to follow this. Let me know through your comments. Thank you.